Finnish kantele. It's the national folk instrument of Finland. Comes in many sizes, from 5-string to 39-string. This one has 29 strings, except when I get up on stage and the spotlights give me twice as many strings. The kantele has been around for probably thousands of years. It was first mentioned in the Finnish national epic, the Kalevala. And in the Kalevala, the poet and sage Väinämöinen builds the first kantele from the jawbone of a pike. The Finns do not like to waste any. And that one was lost at sea, so he built another one out of a birch tree and made the strings out of a maiden's hair. And according to the Kalevala legend, whenever Väinämöinen played the kantele, the music was so sweet that all the animals in the forest stopped to listen. So the song we're going to play is called Kotimani onpi Suomi, which means my homeland is Finland.
It's nice to have a stage crew. I know.
Show our best side.
Check our union card.
Well, we had to look at Ken's for a while.
So thank you for those who signed up to do this. You find that it's interesting because you see different types of playing. And then we have an instrument. How many have seen the kantele before? A few of you.
In a museum.
In a museum. Well, that counts. But it's great. Lee and I met 2 years ago. Yeah, at a Native American flute festival in Pennsylvania. And she started playing that. It's like, okay, I've got to sit down with her and play some music. So we did this, I don't know if it was lunch or breakfast or one of the meals, they have people play. Well, you hear flute music all week. So we thought, let's just do something different. I'll play the dulcimer, you play the cantilet, and then we'll see what happens. Because at meals, nobody's listening anyway. So we had, right. So now we have Jackie and Sylvia.
Okay, the song.
Hello.
Is this?
Yeah.
Is this on? Oh, there. Okay. The song we're doing is called Polly's Song. I'm sorry about the P. And a friend of ours in our group, his name is Tom Miller. He became acquainted with the dulcimer about 4 years ago. And in the last 2 years, he has given me over 200 sheets of music that he has written or arranged for the dulcimer. We're going to play one piece. This one, Polly's Song, actually comes from Beggar's Opera, which was from a three-penny opera 100 years earlier. And it's by Kurt Weill, or Weill. She's going to be playing the melody from that, and then he wrote another accompanying tune that goes with it. So we hope you enjoy this. Capo.
Oh, buoy. That's right. It's down there. Let me show you. All right. Who's got a lovely capo that can run up to me? See, I'm like Nancy here. I just, that's beautiful.
Ooh, I like that one.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. It was wonderful. It's nothing's better than playing in front of friends, because no matter what happens, they're always there for you. Did you get the capo back? I love it. All right. So next we have Anna Stockdale. There she is. Anna's from
Rose.
Rose? Okay, right? What is it?
Rose.
Crozet.
Crozet.
Okay. All right. She's actually apprenticed with those Gaskins, learning the Galax Dulcimer, and quite accomplished. Yeah. She is accomplished. Phyllis will be proud. Phyllis will be proud.
Yes.
All right, next we have the Blue Ridge Players Group. And we have five folks all together. Five. So we'll get things set up here. You can use this one. So go ahead and take that one off. So, hey, they're playing musical chairs right now. Very good. Great chair. Yeah. It's all in the health. Evaluations are back here on this table, as well
probably going over to the Dyer and helping out as many chairs. Does anybody have any questions?
Do you have dates for next year yet?
Yes. Next year's dates is Memorial Day weekend. It's always that weekend. So it looks like it's the 21st to the 24th. Thursday through a little bit of Sunday. I have no idea what's going to take place other than we will have an orchestra. I know that much. So plan on being in the orchestra. She's sitting out there and the orchestra is here. We'll be in the orchestra next year. So everybody had a good time. It's quite a learning experience to be in an orchestra because you have to listen. It's not just you playing. And I know Ken has mentioned this to you. It's all about listening.
I'm not singing.
The musicality
makes a difference.
All right. Ready?
Blue Ridge
Players
Group, right? The Blue Ridge Rockettes.
They're going to do the little kick act under there.
Yeah.
I want to see that. Dulcimer play. Dulcimer Blue Ridge Players.
Well, unfortunately, yesterday I took a little excursion to the winery and missed our practice. And when I got back, they said, Becky, guess what? You're going to introduce the song. It's punishment, I think. But we're playing a beauty. Yes, we're the Blue from the Blue Ridge Mountain Dulcimer Group in the Shenandoah Valley, Virginia, up the Great Valley Road called 81. And you'll pass all of our homes, Bridgewater and Stanton and Wintergreen, Fort Republic.
Greenville,
and of course,
Massanutten.
Okay. Right, yes, all the, and we have a large group, and we'd love for you to go online and look at our website. And we do have a very active group, and we play together with, we just pick and choose, and whoever can come, we play. And so we have a marvelous teacher, Dinah Ansley, and she's our friend and our teacher, and she can't be here today, so we're playing this for her. It is the Skyboat Song by Sue Carpenter. And we have lots of different parts, and we're hoping that you will hear the melody weave in and out. And think about it as you are, you know, on your journey home.